Now, CNN News 18 accesses Rahul Gandhi's plea challenging the trial court order sentencing him to 2 years of imprisonment in the defamation case. The plea claims that the trial court order ought to have seen that documents placed on records are not properly proved and are not admissible further. In this entire petition, Rahul Gandhi argues that there are grave errors of law that has been clearly overlooked by the magistrate court. And it is also said that the complainant wasn't an aggrieved person and had no right to file the case. One of the preliminary objections that Rahul Gandhi and his team has raised is that this particular person who filed this criminal defamation case has no locus standi in this entire matter. Ananya with us on the broadcast. Ananya, the broad limb of the arguments in this appeal.
Well, definitely, Anusha, broad limb of the argument comes in from here. The judgment and conviction order, the sentence passed by the learned CJM is erroneous, patently perverse, and is flagrant violation of the principles of appreciation of evidence in criminal trial, illegal and unwarranted on the facts and circumstances of the case. Now, if I go down on this judgment a little, you can see that the judgment or order of the conviction passed by the learned CJM is bad in law and against the way of evidence. So basically what Rahul Gandhi has constantly been arguing is that there was no kind of evidence that was available on record to actually prove that there were defamation allegations against Rahul Gandhi. And in fact, also he has questioned, he said that the trial court ought to have seen that there wasn't any mens rea in the form of intention to harm or knowledge that it will harm or offense wasn't proved. He also further goes on to say the trial court hasn't considered the ratio of so many judgments that the collections of persons should be identifiable, definite, determinative and well-defined and doesn't discuss at all whether the persons having surname Modi or person known as Modi can be said to be identifiable, definite, determinate as well as well-defined body of persons or not. In fact, in some parts of the order, he has also said that the trial court is erred in believing that the appellant accused did not stop after allegations against Narendra Modi, Nirav Modi, Lalit Modi, Mehul Choksi, Vijay Mallya. He didn't stop, so he had the intention to defame persons named Modi. Why all these have surnames? And if he had the intention to harm Modi, he must not have just stopped at that particular sentence, is what Rahul Gandhi is saying in his appeal. So basically, Rahul Gandhi is saying that, it was not only the Prime Minister or only the Modi community that he had targeted, but he had targeted various other people, including Vijay Mallya, including Mehul Choksi, is what he's going to say in his 45-page appeal that he has filed. We have more paragraphs from this part. The applicant accused summaries that from the above so-called defamatory comments in the are clear that barring one allegedly sentence, i.e. why all thieves are surnamed Modi, all the alleged defamatory comments are against Sri Narendra Modi personally. The applicant accused submits that the respondent complainant is not an aggrieved person to file this complaint so far as the alleged defamatory statement against Sri Narendra Modi.
As my colleague Anand is breaking all the exclusive details, the key limb of the argument that Mr. Rahul Gandhi and his legal team are putting before the Sessions Court, one, is that the complainant did not have a locus. He was not directly aggrieved by the statement of Mr. Gandhi. He did not suffer any kind of damage or loss that can be argued or put forward to a court through certain form of evidence. So that's one part that they're raising. The second argument that the Congress Party, or in fact Mr. Rahul Gandhi legally speaking, are raising before the court is that when that particular statement was made, there was no reference to a community, as is being painted, that the entire Modi community was painted in a certain light. But in fact, Mr. Gandhi wanted to highlight the corruption cases that have come to light. So one on the merit and second on the technicality that there is no locus. Let's see to what extent is the Sessions Court convinced. Ananya Bhatnagar with all the details on that application or the petition that has been made via an appeal to the Sessions Court. All eyes on the next day of hearing. Well, we'll continue tracking this.